Welcome back to my channel. If you saw our last video, you'll know that we skied at Revelstoke Mountain Resort, we enjoyed some local food, and we also explored the Revelstoke Winter Market. We then drove south to Rossland, which is located in the beautiful Kootenay Rockies region of British Columbia. On today's episode, we explore the city of Rossland and ski at Red Mountain Resort. Rossland is well known for their mining of gold from 1891 to 1928. Rossland is now a destination for outdoor adventure enthusiasts. Rossland ranks high among Canada's best outdoor towns. You can find skiing, snowboarding, mountain biking, hiking, cross-country skiing, snowshoeing, golfing, and fishing. Rossland is known as the mountain bike capital of Canada. We enjoyed walking around the quaint downtown of Rossland and through the neighborhoods. Red Mountain Resort is located 2 kilometers or 1.2 miles from the town of Rossland. The resort is known for a 2,919-foot vertical drop and receives over 300 inches of annual snowfall. Red Mountain Resort is a hidden jewel of BC's Kootenay Rockies Powder Highway region.
We made the first chair! We've never made the first chair.
Pretty amazing.
We were on it this morning.
Yep.
It is officially spring skiing. It's very warm and misty and kind of rainy, so we're really wet. Time to pack away the skis.
One way we like to save money is by rarely buying books. My favorite way is participating in these Little Free Libraries, which is a nonprofit organization that promotes neighborhood book exchanges. The library is another way to read free books, although that doesn't work while traveling. However, we use an app called Libby to download ebooks to our Kindles, which is a program offered by our home library, and that allows us to still read library books while traveling. You can also listen to audiobooks through the Libby app. While skiing at Red Mountain in Canada, we stayed at the resort because they allow you to sleep here in your RV for up to 7 days, which is super nice of them. We really love that. But because we are just in a parking lot, there's no facilities, which means no showers. And since we don't have a shower in our RV, we were on the hunt for a shower in Rossland. And Craig had the idea of calling the hostel in town. And they actually allow you to pay $5 for a shower. So we did that, and that was so nice. After spending a couple days in Rossland, we are now packing up and getting ready to head to our next destination. We've started to put this thin foam around the oven door to try to eliminate squeaks, and we also use a bungee cord to attach the oven door to the stove to try to eliminate as many squeaks as possible. And we also take out our dinette table when we drive because it's pretty noisy. It squeaks against the wall over every single bump. And then we also make sure we latch these three drawers in the back because they sometimes pop out when we go around corners.
Just some water.
Okay, trash. Ready to head back to America?
Yep, let's do it.
Got our passports. And I need to get rid of this toothpaste. This is the hemp seed oil toothpaste that got me in trouble. Well, not in trouble, but I got a warning.
I mean, I guess you could keep it with you.
And see.
Then when we get there, just ask them. Be like, hey, I bought this in the U.S.
Yeah.
I don't know why that guard said that. It doesn't really make sense because you bought it in the U.S.
Yeah.
No.
No.
Thank you. Oops, have a nice day.
Thank you. Thank you. Oh my gosh, that was so much easier.
That's really cool. Yeah, he was nice.
Oh my gosh.
We made it.
How easy was that?
It was, yeah, way less time consuming than going into Canada, but maybe we just hit that entry at a bad time.
Yeah, they didn't even inspect our RV. We drove through in probably two minutes.
Right.
He just asked us if we bought anything in Canada, and the only thing we bought was some food and postcards. The only fruit we have is bananas and apples, and that's okay to bring back, but yep. He asked if we had any bell peppers or citrus.
Bell peppers, citrus, there's one other. Tomatoes.
Oh, and tomatoes, which we don't, but I guess if we had those, they would take them because they probably carry certain bugs that they don't want back in the U.S.
I guess so.
And I have some exciting news. I have my toothpaste. I didn't
brought
have to
it
get
home.
Rid of it.
Good thing you didn't throw it away. You would have been upset. You'd go, I knew I should have kept it.
Yeah. So we are now on our way to Schweitzer in Idaho. It's in northern Idaho. And we plan to do some skiing there for a couple of days probably. And Schweitzer's on our icon pass, so that's why we are skiing there.
Dolphins in a new state, Washington.
Woo!
Hasn't been to Washington yet, at least with us.
So. What state are we on? State number...
I gotta count. I believe this is state number 7.
State number 7, and we are in month 3 of traveling.
Month 3.
7 states in 3 months.
They're big states. That doesn't sound like many.
No.
Seems like we've traveled a lot, but
we've been slow traveling on purpose though, because it saves money. The longer you are in one place, the cheaper it is. Thank you so much for watching. We hope you enjoyed this video, and we hope to see you in the next one.